Okay, friends, I've decided that I don't hate the audio on this phone that I'm filming on. So we're gonna try filming with the phone audio. As you can see, I have already sketched today's little gouache moment. Actually, we're gonna see if we use this audio because my rabbit decided to start a construction project. It's fine. Anyway, yeah, so today I am going to be gouaching this fun little idea. I don't know if you guys remember I don't even remember which previous video, but in one of my previous videos, I was like going through here and I was like, yeah, I'm going to totally make this just Scorned related. Yeah, well, you know, things change, so we're not doing that anymore. I'm just gonna do whatever I want because I can. So anyway, if you're wondering about the concept here, I was thinking about submitting to another anthology. And it's like campy, horror themed fun. And I was like, well, what's campier than Elvira, right? But I don't want to like completely copy Elvira. So I was like, let's make her a little different. And while Elvira is like a host for, you know, like reviewing horror movies, basically, like it's just a lot of her work is of her, basically just she's like a hostess watching horror movies and like making fun of them, which we love for her. She's the queen of camp, honestly. And I was like, okay, so the submission is supposed to be like campy horror, so I was like, okay, Elvira inspo, great. And then I was thinking, okay, we need like more to that, like what if it was like an advice column instead of reviewing horror movies. So then I was like, okay, thinking about that. Then I was thinking again of camp and how campy the Halloween Town movies from Disney Channel are. And in one of them, they use a skell phone or spell phone. No, they use a spell phone instead of cell phone. And then my brain was like, I know, skellaphone. Like a skeleton telephone. Ha ha. Hee hee. Oh. So then my ADHD brain was like, okay, we have like show host Elvira Camp telephone advice column. I was like, okay, well, what are we gonna call it? And then I was going through advice column names, and of course, like the most famous one is Dear Abby. And then I was like, what can I play on that? And then it turned into stabby, because Elvira carries a dagger. So I was like, this can be like Elvira's cousin or something, who knows, her other cousin, because her one cousin is definitely Dolly Parton. But yeah, they're both queens of camp. But yeah, so then it turned into Dear Stabby, so it's kind of like this silly horror themed advice thing that you call into and get advice from Stabby here. So I thought that was a fun little play on words. And yeah, so I'm just doing this in my sketchbook for right now, but if I have time to do a submission for that anthology, that would be really, really fun. Would love that. So oh wow, that is opaque. I mean, that's not really like a bad thing. I do find the process of using physical media like gouache to be a lot more like soothing. I don't know. It's like a more meditative process. I think when I do digital, I'm like very, I'm all business. This, I'm just not afraid to get like a little weird. It's also just a very tactile experience. I don't know. Should try it sometime. You don't know what I'm talking about. Oh yeah, so one thing, so I feel like with a lot of these videos, in my imagination, the viewer is, it's like one of those things where the viewer and I are friends and we're just pretending we're on a call and you've gone nonverbal and I'm just the one doing all the talking and you're nodding and going like, yeah, wow, huh, that's crazy. But yeah, because I feel like sometimes, a lot of times, people go to podcasts and YouTube videos because, like, they don't necessarily want to be around other people, but, like, they don't want to feel alone, I guess. So they turn on a podcast, they turn on a YouTube video, you know? So I like to think that we're already friends and that you're just listening to me ramble, as friends do. So, anywho, one of the topics I wanted to ramble about today was kind of this idea that living a balanced life is like kind of low-key impossible, and that life is less of a balancing act and more of a counterbalancing act. And what I mean by that is that, you know, when one thing shifts, everything else shifts, right? Like, it's, I don't know about y'all, but it feels really impossible to, you know, go to work 8-9 hours a day, eat right, like having the energy to like cook and like work out, and then to also just like have a social life and have hobbies and, you know, so you're working a main job and a side gig, and it's just like, how the hell are we supposed to do all of this? Like, this is some tomfoolery in my opinion, to expect people to do all of that. So like, I don't know, I feel like the topic of a lot of my videos is like giving yourself grace, and I mean it, because some of this is goofy. It's goofy to expect yourself to like, I hate when people are like, oh, we have the same 24 hours as Beyonce. And it's like, okay, well, Beyonce, yeah, sure. But she also has, you know, teams of people helping her. And, like, we don't, like, the average person doesn't have that. So it's like, that's just, like, not a fair comparison. And then if you have kids, like, you're, like, even, you're even shorter of like, people to help, it feels like, you know? So, yeah. But yeah, I just feel like that's like also probably why everyone's always just looking for like quick fixes and like quick, you know, I probably should have started with the lighter yellow, but oh well. Everyone's just looking for like quick fixes or for like, oh lordy. Sorry, I'm trying to get another brush. You know, like a magic pill that'll just like make them in shape or like whatever. And it's just like, I think we kind of need to assess the fact that our standards are unrealistic, you know? Cause I know I beat myself up all the time about like not looking a certain way, like that I'd want to look, or, you know, I'm like, oh, I haven't worked out enough. And it's like, yeah, well, you also like work a lot and you commute and you do all these things. And it's like, I'm not saying that's like an excuse to, oh, don't bother chasing your dreams because it's impossible. It's like, no, it's just like, again, life is kind of a counterbalance. So it's like, if you have to kind of decide the things that mean the most to you. So, like, for me, I kind of torture myself all the time because I'm like, I really want comics to be my thing. I would really like for that to become, comics or just some kind of illustration to become my full-time career, you know? And it's like, if I want to do that, I'm gonna have to like put all my eggs in that basket. Like, and again, the counterbalance, like some things are gonna fall by the wayside. And it's like, you want to know what? Like, I'm not gonna be able to have like a bodybuilder physique if I'm putting all this time into other things. You know, like, if I'm putting all of my extra time and energy into art, which is something that I think is worthwhile, you know, I can't be, like, beating myself up for not hitting other goals, because, again, it's, like, this counterbalance. One thing moves, and then everything else shifts and gives. So, yeah, it's like, of course we all want like the freaking supermodel body, and we want the career, and we want like all of these things, you know, the house, the car, the whatever, like we all want things. But I think I'm starting to think it's better to just pick one thing and just really go all in. You know, like, specialization matters. So, I don't know. But hey, what do I know? I'm also, unrelated to what I've just been saying, but I'm, like, really obsessed with doing, like, ombre hair. I don't know why, but I, like, love doing that. It just adds a little dimension, you know? I wanted to give this stabby red hair, like orange hair, because I didn't want her to look like Elvira, obviously, like too much like Elvira, but I also didn't want her to look too much like Dolly Parton either, so I didn't want to make her blonde, so I'm like, all right, she's getting red hair. I'm drinking coffee out of a can, so hopefully I don't accidentally drink from, you know, my paint cup. That would be great. I'm kind of thinking of making her skin like a really light blue. I don't know what is my obsession with redheads that have like bluish skin. That's like a thing that I do a lot. Don't ask me why, but that's where we're going. I think maybe because like the orange and the blue like offset each other. You know, because they're complementary colors. Oh, this is gonna be so fun. These colors are so fun. It's like very like Scooby-Doo situation. Which Scooby-Doo is also so camp. Like, we love that for them. All right, I'm gonna try to just do like a little wash of blue. Like, I don't want her to look like too blue, but just a little, just a bit. Like, I want her to kind of look like a Monster High doll, you feel me? God, can I just say, if Monster High was a thing when I was a kid, y'all, I would have been hounding my mother for those toys. I would have felt so seen as a child if Monster High existed at that time, because I was just such like a creepy, morbid child. Like, that was so my thing my whole life. As like monsters, like campy, villainy, monster stuff. Like, I've just always been obsessed with that, even as like a little girl. And yeah, I would have felt so seen if I had a Monster High doll at that age. It was just like a bit after my time. Like, I remember when Monster High started gaining popularity, it was actually a book series, I think, before it became dolls. And I wish I had discovered that sooner, because I would have been on that like mac on cheese. But Oh well, anyway, it kind of gained popularity like after I, how old was I? Like, I was like on the cusp of adulthood. Like I was like a little too old. I mean, you're kind of never too old to like things. I'm not like hating on adult, you know, doll collectors or anything, but like personally, I just was kind of like, fuck, like, you know, like I think I was like graduating high school or whatever, and I was like, man, like, would have ate this up if I was younger. But yeah, I just felt, personally, I just felt a little older for it. But God, there's the designs, like the story is just so adorable. I'm so obsessed. So obsessed. I'm thinking her dress will be like bright red. I'm kind of just mixing all of my favorite like campy goth women. Like the dress is like kind of Elvira, kind of Vampirella, like, you know. We're just Frankensteining our goth baddies today. I want this to be more purple. This is like way too blue. I'm struggling. It's fine. It's fine. It is just fine. Calling on the skeleton. Speaking of camp and monsters and things that I was obsessed with as a small child, I don't know if any of y'all remember this. This was kind of an obscure thing to like reminisce about, but there was this show. It was a cartoon, and it was originally, I think it was originally a German cartoon, if memory serves, and it was translated into English. And actually, fun fact, it was the narration was done by Elvira in the English version. So this is all coming together, but anyway, this video is really coming together here. But anywho, so Elvira, my queen, narrated this show called The Ketchup Vampires. And I remember whenever I didn't know what I wanted to rent, because we'd go to Blockbuster like every week for like, we'd get movies for the weekend. We did that for a long time in my family. And every week that I didn't know what I wanted, I would literally always pick up the VHS tape for, this is really telling of my age, but I would always pick the VHS tape for The Ketchup Vampires. I've seen it like 100, I've seen it so many times. Okay, 100's a lot, but like I've seen it so many times. And it was just like the cutest little cartoon about this like vegan vampire family. And God, it was just like so wholesome and adorable. Like, and it had Elvira, like her voice literally is like so comforting to me. Like she's just such a good narrator. Like, I don't know. I think I've just always looked up to her, and like, I don't know. It's just such like a good part of my childhood. And I know whenever I feel really lost in life or like really sad, I always want to watch it. And I think I found it on YouTube actually. Somebody posted it. And there's actually two. Okay, so if memory serves, and I might be wrong about this, so don't quote me, but I think it was a show, not a movie in Germany, but when they put it on tape for English release, they just kind of mashed it all together as like two movies, even though it was like basically a TV show. It was like kind of weird. They did that a lot. I don't know if y'all remember like old TV shows, but that was like a common thing. I remember, like, the original It movie, people were like, oh, why is it, like, 9 hours? And it's like, well, it wasn't originally a movie. It was a TV show that they edited into a movie for, like, home release, right? So that was kind of, like, different. Or just, like, a thing that happened a lot. But yeah, so anyway, that happened to The Catch of Vampires, but I was so obsessed. It was so good, like, and I just thought, like, the main characters were so cute, and, like, it's just such a cute show. Yeah, I was just really obsessed. I'm still obsessed. I'd watch it right now. It's just, like, it's just very wholesome, like, feel good, but still, like, Halloween-y and cute, like, you know, like, I find things that are not action or horror themed just kind of bore me. Like, I just think monsters are interesting. Fantasy monsters, they're just infinitely more interesting to me than, like, you know, I don't know, realistic fiction or, like, I mean, don't get me wrong, like, sometimes realistic stuff is metal, but I don't know. I just find a lot of things that aren't, like, fantasy monsters, like, that kind of thing, they just kind of bore me. It's like, if I wanted the real world, I would just, like, go. I would, like, leave my house. You know what I mean? So, yeah. But yeah, Catch Up Vampires. If you're looking for a wholesome, family-friendly, campy, like, goth thing to watch, vampire thing to watch, would highly recommend. It really just takes me back in time. The other thing I would always rent on VHS was all the Goosebumps, the travesty that was the original Goosebumps films. So not the one with Jack Black, but, like, that's, like, the new one where they made it into, like, a proper movie. The old Goosebumps movies from, like, I think it was the 90s. I'm gonna say it's the 90s. They're so dated too, like, I can't, but they're so, like, goofy and, like, poorly done. But me and my sister ate them up. We read all the Goosebumps books, we watched all the Goosebumps tapes, you know, like, I remember too, my old roommate and I, friend/roommate, we went, like, watch all the old Goosebumps. Oh my god, they're just, that's camp. They're so cheesy, so corny, but, like, we loved them. I'm trying to see if that's dry. Lordy. Yeah, those were good times. I'm really not much of a, like, precision gouache painter. So I kind of like to just paint as much as I can and then go back over it with colored pencil. So we're not gonna get too detailed in here today. But yeah. Speaking to spooky things that we like to watch, there is a K-drama that I have not yet finished called Hotel Del Luna, and I was really enjoying it. I was watching it, like, every day at work, and then I just out of the blue stopped watching it. I have to see if it's still on Netflix, because it was pretty good. But yeah, basically the plot is, like, this guy, I don't even remember because it's been a while, but this guy, like, ends up becoming the hospitality manager for a hotel for ghosts, basically, and it's like very much my speed. Very into that. All right, we're gonna give her a sexy red dress. Yeah, this is fun. I'm really enjoying this Scooby-Doo color story. I think also the gouache really lends itself to it because these gouache colors are so vibrant and so pretty. Like, I don't know if it's really showing on camera, but like, damn. Like, damn. I should probably, there's another project I should probably be working on, but you know, we're gonna go where the serotonin is, and we're just gonna paint this, and it's gonna be fine. I also love this idea of like women that are really conventionally attractive, but also like kind of psycho. Like, I think that's fun. Like, or like the Love Witch. Oh my god, I've been meaning to watch that. That looked like such a good movie. But yeah, just like again, conventionally very attractive, but like they do not act conventional, like at all. Like, and I think that's what I like about Elvira, is like she's really hot, but she's also like very weird and like sexy, like not just her looks but like her speech. Like she's not like afraid of her sexuality. Like she's just like very fun and feminine and like silly, and I just love that for her. I've seen Elvira's Haunted Hills so many times. That's like one of my favorite movies. That's another thing, like if I don't know what to watch, I'll just put on Elvira's Haunted Hills. It's again, it's so camp and it's so good. It's just like a very funny movie. I also love it because it almost like seems to imply that Elvira is immortal. Because like she only has two movies, but like the Elvira's Haunted Hills, and correct me if I'm wrong, it seems like it takes place in ye olden times, but it's not really clear. So I feel like the fact that she exists in both like the movie, I don't know if it's just like, I forget, the Elvira movie that takes place in like the modern age, and then Elvira's Haunted Hills. But like, yeah, I don't know. It kind of just implies that she's like been alive for a really long time. It's just very funny to me. But yeah. I just love her. I look up to her. Role model. But it's also funny too, because Cassandra Peterson, like her real self in real life, is like, she is also like a pretty unconventional woman. Like she went to be a Vegas showgirl like really young, and just like made her way, made her career, like, you know. And then she's like, I don't know, she's just never seemed to really like care what other people think. Like she just like does her own thing, and I'm like, god, I just wish I could like be more like that. Like I try to be like that, don't know if I'm succeeding. All right, now the collar, you know, we're gonna paint it red. If we don't like it, we're gonna color over it with colored pencil and everything's gonna be fine. I would love to have a dress like this, not gonna lie. Not that I have the chest to fill it, but, you know, it's fine. My weight goes to the bottom half, you know what I'm saying? Oh, this is so cute. Oh my god. Like I said, we are following the serotonin today. I don't know if I like that brown. Gotta fix it. I also really need to clean this palette. All these colors keep mixing together. Oh my god. It's fine. It's just fine. I'm not even panicking. I'm not even panicking that much. You know what's another, like, kind of horror camp thing that I love is the Clue movie. I used to love playing Clue as a child. But the Clue movie, it's camp. It's great. It's just like that acting is so like over the top and like funny. And it's got Tim Curry in it. Like, of course it's gonna be good, you know? Like that I mentioned like the It movie which had Tim Curry, and now I'm talking about Clue which had Tim Curry. You know, this video script is writing itself. I'm just kidding. I'm kidding, what script? Again, this is a ramble. Like I said, don't even know if I'm gonna use this audio due to various factors, because I feel like my audio for the one that I record on my computer is a little more predictable. It's also got a mic that is it kind of seems to filter out background noises, so we're gonna see how this sounds, and if it makes it to YouTube, then you will know it was a success. That would be great though if I didn't have to like record again for audio. That'd be pretty cool, dude. Like, scoop, the audio worked. I do that all the time, much to other people's annoyance. I just do the Shaggy voice and like say something stupid. Or that one meme. Oh my god. I'm just thinking about that one meme of Scooby. What? Yeah, well, Shaggy's like, Scoob, when they said fix, I thought they meant a sandwich. And then Scooby grabs him and is like, Raggy, where are my resticles? Oh my god, I still think about that. That lives in my head rent-free. Someone in my Discord said, oh, I like the skeleton hands. And I'm like, oh, thank God they look like hands. I was nervous. I was nervous. But yes, they are skeleton hands. They are indeed. Actually, I'm gonna make that like the shadow of like the inside of the hand. I said I was like not much of a precision gouacher, but I'm trying to add some little details. honestly so fun.
You know, I can't imagine living in a time, because, okay, you know how we go into, like, Victorian houses and stuff, and we're like, wow, this is so spooky. And it's like, is it because it's old, or is it because the Victorians were, like, extremely morbid, and it kind of seems to show in their maximalist, like, decorations for some odd reason. That morbidity just seems to, like, permeate everything about Victorian times. Like, is that just me? Am I the only one that thinks that? Because, like, when we go to, you know, the pyramids or, like, Athens, you know, we're like, oh, whoa, like, it's old, but it's, like, cool. Like, I guess if you found a mummy, you'd be like, that's kind of creepy. But, like, you know, like, I don't know when, but for some reason, like, Victorian houses are just, like, really creepy. Like, the haunted house on the hill, it's like almost always a Victorian house, and it's like, I don't know, like, sum up with that. But yeah, the Victorians were super weird. Like, I say the Victorians, the people of like that time period, you know, in the West, they just were like very morbid. I think that's also why, like, so many goths gravitate to that time period, because it's just very, like, first of all, they slayed. Like, the fashion and everything, slayed. Second of all, they were just very creepy. They were, like, very obsessed with, like, creepy things, and it was just, like, socially normal at that time. Yeah, I don't know. It just, I know, like, now is obviously a pretty interesting time to be alive, but yeah, I just think that Victorian England or Victorian era, like, turn of the century, I guess you could say, turn of the century Western places, it's probably a very interesting place and time to be alive. In my opinion. The gothest time to be alive. JK, I don't know when the gothest time to be alive would be. Probably the 80s. Although, okay, I like joke with myself. I feel like goths have always existed. It's just like a matter of what they were called at that time. You know, like, there was always like the edgelord, like, you know, mopey, like, always wears dark colors, like, that character has literally existed since the dawn of humanity, you know, like, there was, like, a caveman swooping his hair, like, you know what I mean? So it's just, like, yeah, I don't know. The Egyptians were pretty goth when you think about it. They actually thought the most, like, important thing you could do was die. So, you know, that obsession with, like, death and stuff, like, eyeliner, you know? I mean, I don't know. So I don't really know when the gothest time to be alive really would be. Could be a lot of times. These colors are such a slay! Oh, I'm having such a good time, you guys. I hope you're having as much fun watching this, you know? I really do. Oh, this looks so cute. I'm so obsessed. All right, I kind of wanted the eye to be blue. And then we can worry about the pupil later. Oh no. Okay. Oh, that looks so cool. Oh my God, I'm obsessed. These colors are so fun and punchy. It'll look so good when I ink it. Oh my gosh. Okay. Not me hyping up my own work. It's fine. Okay, I think... Okay, we need to color the dagger. The hilt. The dagger. If you guys want to know what's going on in my life, I've had a weird day because I was trying to head home from the function I was at, and of course my exit was blocked off, but it's not like one of those moments where it's like, oh, I'll just take the next one and loop around. No, the next one connects to a big scary highway that goes in the complete opposite direction of where I need to be, so I was just like, great. Great. It's fine. So yeah, I got very lost and took a very roundabout way home, but it's fine. I lived, we're here, I'm filming this video, I'm fucking up the dagger, it's fine. It is just fine. I don't think the dagger should be blue. I think I've made a mistake. Cause then it just looks too much like her skin. We might just color that with colored pencil and call it Audrey. Audrey. All right, let's maybe work on the background. I'm quite pleased with the phone. The phone looks insanely cute. I am so obsessed. All right, I'm kind of thinking a wash of some kind in the background. Maybe like this kind of bluish color. Oh yeah, it's all coming together. This is really genuinely reminding me of like the old Scooby-Doo, almost said vintage, the old Scooby-Doos. My favorite Scooby-Doo movie used to be Ghoul School, which is like an older one. It's just such a cute movie. I just seem to be obsessed with like monster girls going to school, like, is what I'm gathering from this video. I want to be a monster girl going to a monster school. That's what I want. Oh no, the graphite. Ugh. I do think this wash is nice. This is fun. This is a fun project. Are you guys having fun? I hope you're having fun. I was cracking up the other day. I was on Discord with some friends doing this like draw challenge. And everyone was like, oh, like, are we still having fun doing this? I was like, guys, I need you to understand, I'm having the time of my life right now. Like, drawing with friends? Like, yeehaw, sign me up. And that sound in the background is my rabbit, so just ignore him. He's fine. I think they like they used to hand paint the old Scooby-Doos, right? Cause like that's kind of like the vibe I'm getting right now. And I'm loving it.
I'm loving it.
McDonald's wants to sponsor me, hit me up. You know, I thought that was dry enough, but it's fine. It's fine.
it's just fine. I probably eat more McDonald's than I should. I'm gonna be totally honest with you. I went like many years without eating McDonald's actually, and then that became not the case anymore. And now I eat it pretty regularly. I should probably use a smaller brush, huh? Paper I got in this sketchbook here is like mixed media paper. I feel like it's handling the watercolor very well. Like I'm like, yeah, it's warping, but not that bad. Like I've used fancy watercolor paper that was like worse than this, and I'm like, this is not bad. These poor bats. I should have painted them later. Yeah, it's giving R.L. Stein. It's giving the Goosebumps. It's giving Scooby-Doo. So one of my best friends, their partner's name is Stu, and I was like, would he be mad if I called him Stubert Dubert? Like Scoobert Dubert, you know? That's like Scooby's full name. Unless I just made that up. I'm pretty sure that's a real fact. But yeah, I don't know why, it just makes me laugh. It's just funny to me. Quite funny. Alright, I think I'm just gonna, you guys get to hear all the weird noises that I make while I'm working. Cause usually I record the audio like after the fact, and you know, in like a separate audio layer file thing. Oh! So yeah, so you're hearing the process now. This looks so good. I'm so pleased. Like, usually I'm like, I just have to trust the process because usually my gouache looks really bad, but this is fun. This is working. It's working today. Oh, that's too much. Oh, that's way too much color. Another horror movie that just popped into my mind was, it's called Revenant. I feel like everyone I talk to that they're like, oh, I love like horror movies and stuff. Like I have a really hard time finding anybody who's seen that movie before. That movie is so, it's like this really dark comedy action movie about a guy who like, gosh, it's been years since I watched it, but he's a revenant. Like he like came back to life after some like horrific thing, and then I forget what I think he's, like, looking for whoever killed him or something. I don't remember, but it's, like, I don't even know if it's advertised as a dark comedy. I'm just gonna paint over this. We're gonna see what happens. I just remember, like, there are parts in it that are so, like, messed up and funny. But yeah, would recommend. Another movie I'd recommend, except it's really sad, is Byzantium. I think that is literally one of the best, most original, refreshing vampire movies I've ever seen. I recommend it to everyone. They're like, oh, like, you're into vampire movies, like, what should I watch? And I'm like, literally Byzantium. It will make you cry, though. That movie made me ugly cry. Ugly cry. But it's really good. And I think it, like I said, it's just very original. Like, I have never seen a vampire movie like it before or since. So, yeah, it's quite good, I'd say. I don't know why I suddenly turned British. It's fine. Don't question it. You know who also suddenly turns British all the time is Brittany Broski, and I love her, so it's fine. I really do love Brittany Broski, like, no joke. She really is, like, the voice inside my head. Like, the voice that narrates my head sounds an awful lot like her. It's quite funny. I wish I was, like, as funny as her, though. Like, God, she is hilarious. Like, I see why she just, like, exploded into fame. Like, she is just so funny. Using too much paint. It's fine. I'm actually surprised I've gotten, like, this much done in one sitting, because, like, a lot of times I have to, like, let it dry more, but we're catching on, I think. Call in on the skelephone. I'm gonna see if I can paint over the blue already because I am impatient. And then I think I'll jump into using colored pencils on Homegirl over here. She's so cute. Yeah, I think once I add some colored pencils, this is really gonna pop off even more. We really got away from, like, the topic I said I was gonna be talking about more. The counterbalance of life. Yeah, so I'm trying to figure out, like, what means the most to me. Because, like, I know for me, it's, like, it's really hard to work a lot and then, like, have the energy to both work out and do art and stuff. So, like, for me, it often feels like one or the other. And I really don't want to be like the, oh, you know, the health doesn't matter. Like, what? Like, you know, I'm not trying to, like, look for an excuse to, like, not work out. It's just, like, it does cut into, like, the little focus time that I have. And, like, I don't know. Like, part of me is just, like, go all in on these things, but then it's like, but the counterbalance, I don't know, like, it's hard.
And then I know some people are just like, oh, well, I do it all. And I'm like, okay, well, some of us have depression. You know, yeah, so it's just like a lot. But yeah, I mean, the more I talk about it, the more I'm like, you know, like, art has always mattered to me so much, and I think, like, I just need to really, like, get more serious. And then I think also one thing I chronically do, I think I need a smaller brush than this, is trying to like wait for a better time to do things. And you're like, oh, well, like maybe now's not the time. And like, yes, sometimes that's true, but also sometimes it's just you getting in your own way. And I'm like, oh, well, you know, if I like wait long enough, I might have like a work from home job and that'll be like easier to do, you know, my personal things, health things, and art. And while that's true, I also feel like if I don't start now, it's like it's now or never, you know? Like if you just keep putting things off until the perfect conditions arise, like then you're never gonna do it. And it's like, I just think it's easier to say, oh, I'll do it then, instead of just starting now. And I think that's partially why I've even started this YouTube channel, is because I'm like, you just have to start it now. You know, and it's like, yeah, is it gonna be perfect? No. And it's like, yeah, if those conditions arise later, great. Then you'll be in an even better place. But if they don't arise, then at least you got started, you know, and you didn't like put it off. So I don't know. I think we all talk ourselves out of a lot of things because we're waiting for those perfect conditions. And I have definitely done it myself. I have done it myself. So trying not to do that. Alright, and then I wanted Skelephone to be in purple. One random thing I just remembered from my childhood that I always thought was funny. My art teacher in elementary school was always like, don't drown your paintbrush. And like, she'd have all these like infographics of like not leaving your paintbrush upside down in the water, you know? And like now that I am an adult and I have my own paintbrushes, I'm like, girl, that's how I keep like the acrylic from drying out. Like, I don't know, maybe I just abuse my brushes, but like I think it's better than letting acrylic or like gouache just like dry on it, right? I don't know, is that just me? But yeah, she was like, stop leaving your brushes in the water, da 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 da, and I'm like, okay, like, I don't know. Not me shading my elementary school art teacher. I think I'm gonna move on to colored pencils. Ooh, she should totally have like purple eyeshadow, I think, maybe. Ooh, it's a little wet.
All right, do we have a lighter purple in here? Maybe, possibly, sort of. We do. Perfect. Excellent. Finally, some good f-ing food. I'm just kidding. You know, like, kids in elementary school would just eat, like, things they were not supposed to eat? I remember one kid, I think he just would do anything on a dare, you know? But I remember one kid in my kindergarten class straight up ate his name tag. And I know what you're all thinking, no, it was not laminated, but it was just like a paper name tag. And every day, like, kids just do the weirdest things. Every day he would take a bite out of it, and by the end of the school year, the teacher was like, Where is your name tag? And he was like, I ate it. And yeah, no, public school is wild. Public school, they really be wild in. I say that like I know anything about private school. I was like, my family could not afford private school. But I like brush shoulders with a lot of like kids that went to Catholic school. And yeah, don't get me wrong, like they wild too, but it's definitely like different. I remember too, like my first day of high school, like I saw all these kids with like, this was also like peak scene kid. Well, maybe not peak. I don't know. See, so like there was like the MySpace era, and then there was like the continuation of like scene, I guess. I don't know, but there were a lot of scene kids in my high school, and I was like, that was like, the first time I'd ever seen people with like colorful hair and like tons of piercings. Some kids even had a tattoo, and I was like, whoa, it's like, this place is sick. Oh yeah, I gotta do these letters too. Alright, I think I might be ready to ink. Are we ready to ink? I'm just gonna take you through this whole process. This is a journey. This is a journey we are on together. Alright. So I got these like knockoff. Well, I don't know. These are like still quality pens, but they're kind of like the, they're Sakura pens, Micron pens. But yeah, so this is like a big pick. All right, let's see. I'm gonna start with the fine liner.
All right, well, I'm quite pleased with this. This is so cute. This was so fun. Thanks for listening to my ramble and hanging out with me. I hope you liked it. And I will see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye.